Good morning, everyone. How's everyone doing today? Awesome. Hallelujah. I'm awesome today, too. The Bible says to enter his gates with thanksgiving and to go into his courts with praise. So let's do that this morning. Let's thank him for who he is, for what he's doing, for what he's gonna do, and then let's praise him for that. Hallelujah. Heavenly Father, we love you so much, and we're here for you this morning. We thank you for all that you are. We thank you for your love and your power and your presence, Lord. We praise you this morning. We exalt your name. We pray that you have your way. In Jesus' name, we love you so much. Amen.
Everywhere to worship with one accord. Father, who all of heaven rose. heavens open and the fire comes down and the wind sweeps through this place. Hallelujah. Will you join your faith with mine this morning? Thank you, Jesus. Won't you come fall fresh on us?
The world will bow down and say you are God. Every knee will bow down and say you are King. So let's start right now. Why would we? The world will bow down and say you are God.
dance like you're waiting for him to come.
And we'll dance in your presence until you come again. Yeah. I will sing hallelujah until you come again. And we'll dance in your presence until you come again.
Come on, sing a louder hallelujah.
Glory.
So worthy of this worship, Lord. We offer it up to you as a sacrifice of our bodies. Hallelujah. Receive this worship this morning, Lord.
Valley.
Hallelujah. Come on, church. We serve an awesome God. We serve a king that's undefeated. We serve a king that looks down from heaven and says, I am pleased with you. He says, I am pleased with what you're doing. He says, I see your sacrifice, and I will bless the work of your hands. But here in the end times, we have a real enemy that works to divide the church. We stand in unity, devil, and we say no. The Apostle Paul pens a letter to the Christians in Rome. And as he ends the letter in chapter 16, he says, be excellent at what is good and be innocent of evil. And family, there's a promise in verse 20 that the God of peace, that the God of peace will soon crush Satan underneath our feet. If you know that your king is working to defeat every work of the enemy, you need to let the devil know now. Satan, your time is limited. And my 9 and a halfs are going all over. Family, you got to make it personal. He's not just against the church as a whole. He's against the believer as an individual. But we stand victorious. Are you ready to receive communion this morning? With great joy. Because our Savior has done it. I said, Jesus has done it. His body he freely gave. His blood is still pouring today. Amen. As you return to your seats, as you sit down for a moment, I want to encourage you. As my brother in Christ, Pastor Steve, and my brother in Christ, Pastor Jeffrey, join me. Can I tell you something? It's a blessing to be here at Crossroads Community Church. Under an anointed man of God, under an anointed people, under an anointed vision, changed life. And it's because of this. Hallelujah. Welcome if you're joining us online. I'm going to give you a few moments. You could go to your cupboards, you could go to your refrigerator, grab some bread, grab some juice. We're going to remember everything that Jesus did. That's how the God of peace crushes Satan. Because of what his son did on the cross. And we are partakers of that. Hallelujah. Come on, can somebody say hallelujah for that? Hallelujah. Glory to God. I want to encourage you. Take a moment and reflect. Search your heart. Before we receive communion, take a moment and ask the Lord to show you things. Things you may not have thought of. But let's make sure that we receive the body and blood of Christ with a clear conscience. And two of the most powerful words in the English language are, I'm sorry. Just ask the Lord for forgiveness, and he is faithful to do so. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I love what 1 Corinthians says about the body of Christ. But when you go into chapter 12, verse 12, it says the human body has many parts. But many parts make up one whole body. So it is with the body of Christ. I think God sent his son Jesus. He gave up his body so that we could be the body of Christ. The holy transfer. That's why we take the bread and the cup to, in remembrance, to say, okay, God, this is what you did for me. Now I'm going to live like the body of Christ. I'm going to do what your word tells me to do. I'm going to live like you told me to live. Amen.
Church, like my brother said when he was doing the transition, make this personal. Don't forget what Jesus did on that cross. It's not about us becoming a Christian and getting saved and then forgetting it. What he did is everything. There is nothing more important than that cross. Listen to what the book of Hebrews says. You have come to Jesus, the one who mediates the new covenant between God and his people, and through the sprinkled blood, which speaks forgiveness instead of crying out for vengeance, like the blood of Abel. You see, human blood, Abel, can't kill them. And God says in the word that the blood spoke to him from the ground. But see, the blood of Jesus, it speaks forgiveness. It speaks for us when we believe in him as our Savior, that we are redeemed. Man, no matter what is going on in this world today, stand on that foundation of what Jesus did on that cross, and we are forgiven.
Father, we thank you for sending your Son. We remember that the very night that Jesus was betrayed, he looked to the Father once again. And he took the bread and he gave thanks. And then he broke it and he gave it to his disciples and he said, "This is my body which I freely give for you." The body of Christ is what sustains us, remembering his sacrifice. And the spirit that he loosed is what sustains us as believers. You may partake. And in the same way, he took the cup after dinner. And he lifted it up and he said, "This is the cup of the new covenant, the cup of my blood, which I freely pour out." He is faithful. He is just. Not only will he forgive, but he will fight for you. And he lifted up the cup of his blood and he said, "This is the blood that I pour out of the new covenant. Do this in remembrance of me." You may partake. Thank you, Lord. We honor you. We give you all the glory this morning. Can we thank him? Can we thank the Lord for everything that he did? Thank you, Pastor Jeffrey. If the ushers could come grab the table. Listen, if this is your very first time here at Crossroads Community Church, welcome. We're glad that you're here. My name is Pastor Roberto Cespedes. I am the executive pastor here under an amazing man of God that came here 15 years ago with a big shovel called the Holy Ghost and started digging. And you're a byproduct of that work, and so am I. Can we give it up for all that God's done over the last 15 years? Listen, you want to be a part of this. If this is your first experience here, there's a connection card in the seat pocket in front of you. All you got to do is grab it and fill it out. And also, we've got a ministry called Growth Track each and every week that will be a great first step for you. So if you haven't participated in Growth Track, we want to offer that invitation to you now. For those joining us online, it's really simple. If you've never seen the broadcast before, just drop the number 1. Right into the comments. And if you're interested in Growth Track and getting to know a little bit more about Crossroads Community Church and the body of believers here, just drop GT right in the comments. Now, we're an active, moving, growing church, whether you're 3 months, 3 years old, 13, 30, 333. Listen, we will engage you with the love and power of God. Can we say next gen? I'm sorry, Pastor, what was that? Can we say next gen? That's better. That sounds like the crossroads I know. Hallelujah. Pastor Jeffrey and Stephanie are training up another amazing couple. Could you please stand, please, Morris? That's right. See, the kingdom of God forcefully advances, and when you raise other people up, God continues to grow the church and grow you. Amen? That's what Pastor Brian does. He raises up ministers and he releases them, and that's what his staff does as well. Can I honor you, Pastor Jeffrey, and your beautiful bride? Great job, my friend. Great job. Now, here's how we respond to what God's doing. Fill the house. Somebody say, fill the house. Hallelujah. Let's believe that this is going to be the next gen sanctuary soon, and we're going to need a new building. Let's believe that every kid at Fitchburg High, that every kid at Longshore hears the word of God and changes from the inside out. That sounds good, but here's the practical thing that you've got to do. He works through us. Here's a very practical thing you got to do is bring your kids and bring your friends' kids and bring their friends' kids. And let's believe for an outpouring. Joel 2:20 says he will pour out his spirit on 3, 13, 30. 333. I don't know if Methuselah will come back from the grave or what, but God has a purpose, irrespective of your age, and we are the instruments that bring people to the church. Let me tell you something. The devil's working, so nobody goes to church. But verse 20 says, the God of peace in Romans 16 will crush Satan. I want to encourage you, fill the house. Let's believe for next gen youth group. Let's pray really quickly. Lord, I pray that you will activate the supernatural through the Holy Spirit upon our young people, God. I know, Lord, that you have a plan and a purpose that's mightier than anything that they think. So pour out dreams. Pour out visions. Pour out your power. Let the conversations begin at home. May parents be open to what you're teaching their children and receive. And I pray that here, on Mount Zion in Fitchburg, that from the north, the south, the east, and the west, that you will bring young people to receive the word of God. We ask this in the name of your son, Jesus Christ. And all of God's people said, amen. Hallelujah. We just prayed together, and I'm going to encourage you to do that again. This Tuesday at 7 o'clock, we've got prayer. See, we've got to do something in the supernatural for it to manifest in the natural. So join us, amen. Now we get to receive an offering for this ministry. Come on. I said we get to receive an offering for this ministry. I'm going to give you something from the Word of God. Proverbs chapter 11, verse 10. We're going to read this together in the New International Version. See, that abundant life in John 10, 10, that prosperity that we speak of in Jeremiah 29, 11 has a purpose. Let's read this together. When the righteous prosper, the city rejoices. When the wicked perish, there are shouts of joy. Hallelujah. Verse 11, through the blessing of the upright. We just received communion. I don't care what lie the devil tells you, you are righteous. You are upright because of what Jesus did. Through the blessing of the upright, the city is exalted. And by the mouth, devil shut up, the mouth of the wicked, it is destroyed. Hallelujah. Every time you do something that's got Jesus on it, you are kicking the devil in the teeth. Hallelujah. I want to encourage you, as the ushers come forward, these seats that you're sitting in, the 15 years, the big old shovel, you're part of it. You're a piece of that shovel. You're a piece of that work that God's doing. And as you're faithful to the house of God and to the vision of God, you will continue to see change in your family and your friends. I say thank you on behalf of this body, on behalf of our pastor, on behalf of this staff. I say thank you for your faithfulness. the Lord is pleased, and every single work of the enemy will be shown as what it is, will be turned around for the goodness and the glory of God, and you will see a manifestation in your life. Let me pray for you. Heavenly Father, I am so thankful to be a part of an amazing body of Christ that's standing strong on the Word of God. Lord, we offer this to you as gratitude for your goodness, Lord. Lord, receive this tithe, receive this offering. We know that you're already pleased with us, but pour it out so that this city will be elevated and the anointing of God will be poured out in a way that people will begin to testify that everything that you're doing will come to the natural, that we will see eyes opened, ears open, and people redeemed and snatched from the pit of hell. We love you, Lord. We give you all the glory and honor in Jesus' name. And all of God's people said, God bless you this morning, family.
Thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lift up the mighty King. Come on, let's just stand to our feet for a few moments. Let's just lift our hands to the Lord. Come on. Hallelujah. Let's ask Him to turn over the hearts a little bit. Amen. Hallelujah. Stir up the fire. Come on. Hallelujah. Come on, lift your hands to the Lord, all ye people, and make a shout of joy. Hallelujah, for our God lives. He's not dead. He's still alive. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on. We enter His gates with thanksgiving. Just begin to thank God with your mouth right now. Come on, whatever He's done for you in your life, you need to thank Him for it right now, according to His grace and His mercy. Come on, thank the Lord, all ye people. Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord with your mouth. Come on. Thank the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank Him. Thank Him. Thank Him. Hallelujah. Come on. If you want Him to do anything more for you in your life, you need to thank Him for what He's already done. Hallelujah. Come on. Thank Him that your kids know Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank Him that He's got provision on the table for you. Thank Him for your job. Thank Him for your health. Thank Him right now for all that He's done. Don't think about what you don't have. Think about what you do have. Come on. What's inside of you is greater than anything that's on the outside of you. Thank Him with your mouth. I thank you, Lord. I wake up thanking Him and I go to bed thanking Him. Hallelujah. 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 Come on. You guys are giving a week Thanksgiving. Come on. Come on. If you want your heart on fire, you've got to use your mouth. I said, you've got to use your mouth. You have to declare your faith. You use your mouth to say what you want and have what you say. Use your mouth to thank the Lord. Come on. You're starting to sound better. Better, better, better. Thank Him. Stand up, sir. Come on, you've got to have something to thank God for. Thank Him right now. Come on, He'll open up doors if you can open up your mouth. Come on, He'll open up doors if you can open up your mouth. Lift your hands to the Lord. Come on, praise Him. He's worthy of praise no matter what's going on, no matter what's happening. He's worthy. Thank Him, thank Him. Thank Him that you're still alive. Thank Him that you still got something left. Thank Him that there's a remnant. Thank Him that you're still in church. Come on. Thank Him that the church doors are open. Thank Him that, hallelujah, that His Spirit is alive and well in you. Come on, stir up that gift, Timothy. Stir it up. Rekindle the fire. Yes, we got some on fuego. Come on, go get that, girl. Hey, sound good. All right, that's level one. Level one. Level one. Level two. Let's level up. Come on, let's begin to praise Him. Come on, praise the Lord, all ye people. Let everything that has breath praise ye the Lord. Come on, praise Him. I said praise Him. There you go. Some people are getting happy. Get happy. Come on. Some people get happy. Some people get sad. Come on. Some people scream. Some people shout. Some people laugh. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. Come on, freedom. Thank Him that your marriage is still alive. Come on, thank Him that He's working on your behalf. Praise the Lord, all ye people. Here, let me just put your hands down for a second. Just for a second. Look at me. Look at me. If you don't praise Him, the Bible says that the rocks will cry out. I've made a determination in my life, ain't no rock gonna cry for me. Ain't no rock gonna praise Him for me. Hallelujah. No rock is going to speak for me other than the rock called Jesus Christ. Come on, and Him crucified. Now listen. You know, this is the United States of America. Friend, we live in the land of the free. I know it don't seem like it right now. Okay? But it's still a free country. Okay? It's the home of the brave. This isn't the land of the lockdown and the home of the fearful. This is the land of the free. I said, you are free people. Amen. We have a constitution that says you're free. Come on, we've got a Bible that says we're free, and he who the Son sets free is free indeed. Now you need to praise him like free people. You need to praise him that you are not in lockdown. You need to praise him as if he's still on the throne. You need to praise him as if you're going to see him tomorrow. You need to praise the Lord, all ye people. Yeah, you sound good. You sound good, 9 a.m. Yeah. Yeah, baby. Come on, this is the church of Jesus Christ, baby. Hallelujah. Woo. Hey, now I want you to put your hands on the Lord. Hallelujah. And let him touch your heart. Come on, let him heal your heart. Come on. Let him heal him. Let it heal your heart of all the hurts. Come on, let him touch your heart today. Don't guard your heart from him. Guard your heart from the Antichrist, the one who wants to kill you. Open up your heart to Jesus and let the flood of his presence come into your spirit today. He'll change your life. He'll change your atmosphere. He'll change your family. Come on, he'll change your children. If you can just put the Lord first, seek the Lord while he may be found, and put the kingdom of God in. Seek the Lord first. And the Bible says that all things will be added unto you. Primero. Cristo primero. Okay, Don Camaro? Now lift up your hands one more time. Let me prophesy over you today that this week will be a week of encounters for you. That this week will be a week of encounters for you. Come on, I'm telling you today, if you can get your praise through, you can grab a hold of your breakthrough as it is on earth, as it is in heaven, and as it is in heaven, may it be on earth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, as you put your hands to the Lord, what we are doing is we are surrendering to his majesty, his kingship over our lives. Hallelujah. And you cannot put God first and finish last. Okay? We put him first in our lives, and the Bible says that if we lift up the name of Jesus, it'll cause all men to come unto you. All these things will be added to your life as you put the kingdom of God first. As we lift up our hands, Father, I pray right now that your spirit would come down and you would fill your people to a fullness this morning, a fullness that overflows everywhere that they go. I pray for all those that are watching online. Friends, you can participate. Put your hands to the Lord. Now just begin to thank and praise him right now. Come on, as if your life depended on it. As if you were standing in front of his throne on the day of judgment. Come on. How thankful would you be if you made it into heaven? Hallelujah. How thankful would it be the minute you step into your mansion that he's got prepared for you? Come on, the room, the place, whatever he's got for you. How thankful would you be to be the one counted worthy of his glory? Come on, I am so thankful. Hallelujah. Hallelujah! 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 Now say his name. Say Jesus. Say Jesus. Say Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Now praise the Lord. Come on and let every demon in hell know that you are a child of the Most High God. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Hey! Now on the count of three, let's let every demonic presence that's even close to this place feel the reverberation of our praise to our mighty God with a big shout on the count of three. Come on. One, two, three. Hey! Hey! Come on, hey! Woo! We win! He won! It's over, baby! It's over! Your time of waiting is over. How priceless is the name that is glorious. With every head bowed, every eye closed. Lord, on behalf of your people, I stand in the gap, God. I stand in the gap for their marriage. I stand in the gap for their children. Lord, I stand in the gap for their prosperity, that you would lead them out of poverty and into your prosperity that only comes from your mighty hand. Lord, I pray for their faith. I stand in the gap. I stand in the gap for all of their sins. And Lord, I pray that at the end of the service, that every single person at the sound of my voice gets right with you. Lord, I pray that as they listen to the message of faith today, that, Lord, you build them up in their most holy faith. And Lord, I pray right now that this church would go out into the highways and the byways preaching the message of the gospel, the good news that Jesus came down from heaven to this earth so that men and women from this earth can make it to heaven. And Father, we are thankful for the gifts that you give to the body. I pray for them now. I pray for their increase in Jesus' name. And if that sounds good to you, say amen.
Amen.
Now, one more moment. Let's not move from here. These are holy moments as a body that we celebrate the Lord. We just had communion. It's a day of remembering. It's not just a day of remembering, it's a day of participating. Don't be a spectator in the house of God. Be a participator. Amen? Put me in, coach. I'm ready to play. With every head bowed and every eye closed, let's just remember, Lord, you are awesome in this place. Mighty God, you are awesome in this place. Abba Father, you are worthy of all praise. To you our lives we raise. You are awesome in this place, mighty God. As I come into your presence, past the gates of praise, into your sanctuary, where we're standing face to face. We look upon your countenance, I see the fullness of your grace, and I can only bow down and say, you are awesome in this place. Oh, you sound good. You are awesome in this place. Abba Father, you are worthy of all praise. To you our lives we raise. You are awesome in this place, mighty God. Hallelujah. Come on, hallelujah. Come on, hallelujah. Because you're holy, you are holy, Lord, so holy. What a privilege and an honor is to worship at your throne, to be called. You are worthy, Lord. Isn't he worthy? Isn't he worthy for our praise and all of our praise? Hasn't he done so much? Look at the work of the Lord's mighty hands. Look at all the lives that have been changed. Look at the great work he's done. Look at all the hearts that have come back to God. Look at all the miracles. Look at all the testimonies. Look at all the businesses. Look at all the prosperity. Come on, we're in Fitchburg, Massachusetts, and I promise you we are one of the strongest churches in this entire region. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is pouring out his spirit right here at Crossroads Community Church. Come and see all that the Lord has done. Hallelujah. You may be seated for a minute. I want to thank all. Give these guys a mighty praise offering. Hallelujah. Where's that microphone? Let me see that for a second. Hallelujah. Man, I just got touched. I actually got touched in the shower this morning. I got up early. I prayed for you. Prayed for your families. I prayed for your business. Come on, how many have been blessed since they've come to the Lord? Come on, how many have prospered since they've met Jesus? Hallelujah. How many know that's what he does? He brings increase. He's a multiplier. That's what he does. That's what he does. And if he hasn't done it yet in your life, we're going to get it right today, and you're going up in Jesus' name. Amen. But I want you to hear testimonies. We used to do a testimony Sunday. We used to put microphones in the old church on the corners, and there would just be long. Hallelujah. He's still working today. It even in a greater fashion, I promise you, if we set this as a testimony Sunday and we put microphones in all these rows, these lines would just, everybody would be out of their seats testifying. Yeah. Amen? Yeah. But I'm going to hear some recent testimonies, some powerful stuff. Now, I'm just going to start calling people out. I didn't even know I'm going to invite them to this platform. Okay? I want you, sir. Why don't you come up and give a testimony of what God did.
Good morning, church. Good morning. It's hard not to smile today.
Tell them why you're happy.
Most of you know, Jack and I are looking to buy a new house and move and get out of Pittsburgh and just do what's best for our family. And takes a lot of prayer to know when. You know, we've been waiting, God, when? When do we step? And I was a little hesitant. I've been in the same home for 15 years.
He ain't running from Fitchburg because it's a bad place.
No,
he's running
no.
from Fitchburg because he wants land.
I want land. I want to be in the woods with my kids. I want them to be able to play. And, like, it's not, Pittsburgh's my home. This is where I bleed. This is where I live. This is my home. But we wanted more property for the kids and to expand. And anyways, we prayed. We waited. I waited a little too long. But anyways, that's what we do. So we prayed, and we found the house that we wanted, and it went under agreement, and we were like, uh-oh, is that not the right house? Came back on agreement. We went and saw it. They accepted our offer, and we bought the home before we even put our home on the market or sold it or anything. So then we put our house on the market, and people started to come see it, and thank you for anyone who came and helped in the house and all that, too. The body of Christ is amazing. True family, closer than a brother. And 30-plus people had come through the house and loved the house and absolutely loved it, and no one had made an offer. So faith was a conversation that we were having deep at home. Tears at the table, digging out the word, really trying to say, where is our faith? What are you doing, God? And a brother in Christ here in the church encouraged us through prayer to you're talking about faith and you're praying about faith, but what are you doing about it? I said, well, he says, you need to activate your faith. You need to take a seed and sow it in faith to unlock the supernatural cell of your house. Well, finances are tight. We bought a house and we haven't sold a house. So we're like, wait a minute, we don't have it. And but we received his love and we went into prayer. And separately, God told her a number, told me a number. And we came in unity the next morning. And, of course, the number was what it was. And we went and sowed our seed. Well, we had 3 showings in the house that day. And we sowed our seed at 4 p.m. in the afternoon, and there was a weird showing at 5:45 at night, which was odd and weird. But we showed it then, and then we showed two afterwards. And end of the night, there was no news, no anything. And we're at the kitchen table, and we're talking about faith. Tears are flowing between Jackie and I, and she's like, okay, if this is what we're going to do, and we're going to really dig into faith, she says, your faith is there today. Where's your faith going to be in 3 days? That's exactly where it is. I'm not questioning whether he will or he won't. My flesh is questioning when. And that's fear. But I know he will. And she went, okay. She went upstairs, grabbed the Bible, threw it on the bed, and said, this is what we're doing tonight. We're not even going to sleep. This is what we're doing. So she went to get ready for bed. Well, while she was doing that, the realtor called. And that showing that was the very next one after the 4 o'clock seed that we sowed, put in a full offer for the house to buy the house. And it's even better than that because he's a contractor and he could care less about a home inspection and he doesn't really care if the house doesn't meet it. Because I'm buying a 100-year-old house. It's going to have issues. I just want the home. I want my children to grow up in this home. So God's favor is just moving abundantly. And it's the faith principles that we are taught here by you and by this body to believe, truly believe. Because, I mean, we all are at different levels and different walks, and faith is a big topic at home today. And it's
yeah,
big. It's
yeah.
growing.
Yeah, you can talk about it when you start seeing manifestation, right?
When you unlock it and it starts to come, woo, you can just brag on them.
Jay, as you put your hand to the Lord, I just pray that that's just the beginning of all that God does through faith. Lord, I pray right now that, Lord, you just continue to bless him. As many of you don't know, Jay had a problem with his heart. He had cardiomyopathy. That's where his arteries began to get plaque, and he was operating on about 8% of his heart. And he couldn't even go up and down stairs without, they gave him 3 to 5 years maximum to live. That was 8 years ago, by the way. God healed his heart completely. Amen. And the doctors are astounded, and they're just completely blown away about all that God did with them. Hallelujah. And I pray that as you get a new heart, hallelujah, you also get everything else that comes with it. Everything else becomes brand new in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. And Lord, I pray that you continue to bless him in his faith. Lord, meet his faith with your power, and let the miraculous continue to take place in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Talitha, I want you to come up, and I want you to share your story of how you got your home. That's like a, that's just, you just got to tell it.
Okay.
Okay.
In a really short.
Do your thing.
So I had been wanting to move closer to Fitchburg, but we also wanted land. And there was a house that was for sale just down the road, and it was perfect.
Across the street.
Across the street, basically. And it went off the market, and we were just looking. We hadn't even gotten approved for a mortgage yet or anything like that. And a couple of years later, it's back on the market again. So I tell Michelle Matthew, who is a realtor here. She's awesome. She was like, oh, sorry, T, it's off the market again. It's in contract. So I was like, all right, it's not God's will. But then a couple weeks later, she calls me again. And she's like, it came back on the market. I'm like, let's go look at it right now. I took my niece Courtney with me. We went inside, and I immediately knew that it was our house. Now, we hadn't gotten approved for a mortgage. We had a little bit of money saved, but we basically had nothing at that time. So I said, okay, Lord, if this is my house, then I'm going to offer a really low number, and you're going to give it to me.
We prayed in your office that God would give you the home, too.
That's right. And we sowed a seed. And so we ended up getting that house for a third of what they were asking
for. Tell them how much. Tell them how much. Tell them how much.
We ended up getting the house for $50,000.
Who buys a home for $50,000? The men and women of God do.
Yes.
Right? Amen. Let me tell you something, okay? They put some money into that house. That's probably worth about 5 times more than that right now. Yeah. For the glory, easy, right? And so, hallelujah. I pray that that's just the first, not just the first. I know there's been many more after that. But at that same faith that brought you that house, I pray that it brings you all things that God gives you guys, the desires of your heart, that he unlocks doors that only he can unlock. And I pray that it happens by the end of this year, In Jesus' name, amen. 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 Great, great. Friends, these are stories of faith. Faith unlocks the supernatural power of God. I said faith unlocks the supernatural power of God. Amen. God will not only bless your business, he'll bless your faith. God will not only bless your home, he'll bless your faith. You know what God responds to? Faith. You know why? Because it comes from God. God has to answer faith because that's what he's given us to operate with. Can someone say amen? Now, in each one of these testimonies, there was always an instruction. Amen? God will tell you what to do. And then when you do it, you have to do it in faith. And it's that faith, it's the supernatural currency that unlocks the door. Wesley, why don't you come up? Sorry, sir. Oh, you might have one too, okay. Wesley got something. Cue that up. You all know the evangelist Wesley Agray, right? Hallelujah. Do you have school debt?
No.
No?
Well,
I know you're starting a new semester, but you're putting that in the hands of God too, right?
Yeah.
Tell them the miracle. Go ahead.
Okay. I think it was.
Yeah, flick it. There you go.
I think it was about 2 years ago. I had about $4,000 in like school debt, and you know, obviously, debt's not a sin, but it weighs you down and it stops you from doing what God wants you to be able to do more freely. So I was praying, and I think it was in the fall because Jonathan was coming, either September or something of that year. And I said, Lord, you know, I'm just stuck where I am. Like, I'm not advancing any further where I want to spiritually, and I have this money that I still owe for school. So I said, God, you said if I sow a seed, I can break through to whatever it is that you want me to do. And the Bible says in Genesis that the seed is within itself. So in your seed is the power to do anything that you need it to do for you, right? And so I said, Lord, I need to advance spiritually here, and I need to break this debt that's, you know, going to hold me back if I don't get it paid off. So the Lord spoke to me a number of what I was to sow, and it was pretty big for me. It was essentially, I calculated it after, it was pretty much the sum total of everything I had made working that summer. And I said, Lord, I'm going to do this. So I wrote a check out for that amount, and Pastor brought me in the green room Sunday, I think it was Sunday morning service when Jonathan was here, and I gave him this check, and I said, the Lord told me to give this to you. And that was it. I gave it, and I said, Lord, I believe this is it. Debt's canceled in my life, and I'm, you know, stepping into a higher realm spiritually. I think it was 3 days later, Jonathan had just showed a video of one of his crusades, and he came up to me right after. I remember I was sitting probably right where T was sitting right now, and he said, how much do you have left to pay on your school bill? And I said, I don't know, I think like $6,000. He goes, done. I'm covering it. And so he had wrote a check, and it actually turned out to be, I think, about $7,500. And Patrick, just crazy. And so he wrote that check out completely, sent it to the school, and my debt was paid off there completely, and then I actually had an overflow, I think, of about $3,500. And I'll be one of the only students in my graduating class to graduate debt-free and owe nothing to the Bible College. Amen.
As you lift your hands to the Lord, I pray that all that rest of that money comes into your ministry right now. Every single dollar that you're going to need for this tuition this year is going to come into your ministry. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, by faith. And if you say amen, it shall come.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you. Glory. You got a faith testimony? All right, come on up. What's your name?
Steve.
Come on, Steve. No preaching. Just testifying, okay? Okay.
Okay, I had an accident, a foot accident that, minor, nothing, okay? So I didn't think nothing of it. What happened was is that a blood clot went from my foot to my lungs and gave me a small stroke. Now, I had the third best cardiologist in the country. I said, don't sugarcoat anything. I was on a machine, a breathing machine, because I was day-to-day for 3 months. They said, you're not going to, you know, we got you on the medicine now, but if you want to call an ambulance, we're going to do the same thing as you're doing right now. So it's either you got to make it here on this machine. For 3 months, I was day to day. And my girl gave me this white little lamb. And the white is about as dirty as this now. I held it every single night. For day to day, I didn't know if I was going to make it. They said, I'm going to be on oxygen for the rest of my life. I'm never going to walk again. If you watch me, I walk a little messed up still, but I'm not going to walk. I need oxygen forever. Are you sure? 100% sure. I've been boxing since I was 13. I said, I'm not going to lay here. I laid there for 9 months, and here's my first day outside. I beat everything. I went outside. I said, I'm not going to lie here and die. I got up. It took me. I'm in the Church of God. It took me 8 months. I had a commode by the couch. She laid by me every single night and cried. I'm like, no, that's not helping. That's not helping. You can't be crying. I mean, I'm holding the lamb, and the lamb's not crying, so you can't cry. The lamb. I got pictures of me and the lamb, too, but this is me the first day outside. After 8 months, it took me 6 months. It took me just to get up and I said, I'm going to take a step today. I said, I'm not going to lay here and die. I took a step, and I sat back down.
Yeah.
Next day,
come on.
I tried to take two. I almost fell.
Yeah, yeah.
6 months, it took me to get to the sink, but I did it. And I said, yeah, all right. Now I'm going to try to go to the bathroom without this thing. I had an oxygen line that was on the wall. All the way, it was 400 feet long, the oxygen line, just because everywhere I went, I had to have oxygen. And in this picture, I have oxygen outside. You're going to need oxygen for the rest of your life, and you're never going to walk again. I'm in the process right now of getting something else fixed. That's why I walk a little messed up. But I'm in law enforcement for a while, and everybody, all three specialists, as I hold my cross, counted me out. You're done. This is going to happen. No, it isn't. Me and the lamb are going to walk out of here. That's where I am right now.
As you put your hands to the Lord. Father, I pray that, Lord, you just make everything line up now for your glory, God. Lord, as I put my hands on him, let the power of God come on his body. Lord, I pray that what's on me gets on him, God. I pray it's in a greater fashion. We're thankful for his faith, but Lord, take it to another level, God. I said, take it to another level. Lord, I pray right now that he will run and he will not get tired, that he will walk and he'll never faint, God. And Father, we thank you for your mighty power, Lord. Let him soar like an eagle in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. May he never, ever be the same. Let him always get better, better, better in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What a great testimony. Hallelujah. Come on. How many are being encouraged in their faith right now? Our God is a miracle working God. He can do the miraculous. He can do the impossible. I said he can do the impossible. With man, certain things are impossible. But with God, all things are possible to him who believes. Amen. Hold on, let me turn off these drums real quick here. Okay. Sorry about that. Hallelujah. Okay. Just, yeah, not really. Comes with the phone. Can't get rid of it. Tried it. Listen to this. Last week, if you haven't watched the message, you have to go back and watch it. You have to. I titled the message, Hearts on Fire. I've been studying 1 and 2 Timothy and Titus, the pastoral epistles. This is letters to leaders. I feel like I'm a leader of leaders. This room is full of leaders. I said, this room is full of leaders. Amen? You're leading something. You're leading your families. How many are leading their families? How many are supposed to be leading their families? Lead. But leaders are also followers. Pastors have pastors. 1 and 2 Timothy and Titus is all about false teaching. Self-asceticism. People that just go off and do their own thing. The rogue agents. Gives instructions for how the church should begin to operate. Now, that's not the start all and the end all in 1 Timothy. But Paul gives some warnings and some things to put in place for the problems that Pastor Timothy was dealing with at Ephesus. 2 Timothy was more of a personal letter to Timothy to strengthen him. We preached out of 2 Timothy, hallelujah, chapter 1, verse 5 through 7, that Timothy's fire was going, it was starting to dissipate. It was starting to burn out. I've been in ministry for 15 years. If you don't guard the fire, if you don't watch the fire, if you don't attend to the fire will go out. The fire will go out. How many people we got on fire up in here this morning? Come on, who's got the fuego? Fuego of the Holy Ghost. Right? Right? Get on fire and stay on fire. If you tend to the fire and if you stir up, that's what the Apostle Paul was telling Pastor Timothy. Stir up the fire, man. Stir it up. And we talked about that fire being the faith of God. Jesus came to baptize us in the Holy Ghost and fire. Say it again, the Holy Ghost and
fire.
Are they the same thing?
No.
No. No. I believe personally that the fire is faith. You know what gets me excited? Faith. You know what lights me on fire? Faith. Anytime God meets a manifestation to my expectation, hallelujah, it doesn't end up in frustration. It ends up in exhilaration. I get exhilarated. I go from faith to faith. I don't believe God for the same things over and over and over again. I believe God for new things. We are in a new season and in a new cycle, my friend. Say it. New season?
New season.
New cycle.
New cycle.
New cycle.
New cycle.
This is the 8th year of our revival church.
Amen.
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 We got revived about 8 years ago.
Amen.
Revived. We were vital. We revived, but we needed to be revived. Why? Because the same thing that Pastor Timothy was experiencing, any pastor could experience. Any church could go through stagnancy. Listen, you're not called to be a pew warmer. Okay? You're not on the bench permanently. You know, you got to at some point say, put me in, coach. This is an all play. There are lost and dying people all around each and every one of us. It's our responsibility. We've all been given the ministry of reconciliation. So listen to Paul's exhortation to Pastor Timothy in 1 Timothy chapter 4. I'm going to leave you with this. He says in verse 14, do not neglect the spiritual gift you received through the prophecy spoken over you when the elders of the church laid their hands on you. Is this a church that lays hands on people?
Yeah.
You bet. You know why? Because it's what we see in the Bible. Well, we don't really lay hands on people in our church. What's the wrong church? You see in the book of Acts that they got filled with the Holy Ghost when they laid hands on the believers. They got saved, but then they got filled. Amen? Because in order to stay saved, you need to be filled. Now, I know some people are going to disagree with that. Go ahead. I don't care. Okay? You need to be full of the Holy Spirit. Not just a measure of the Holy Spirit, you need to be full. Jesus came and died so that we could live a very productive and full life. He says, I have come that you might have I have come that you might have
life.
That's not a dead church. Full of dead people. With a dead message. You know, this isn't a mortuary. We're not here to bury you. We're here to revive you. We're here for you to come alive. Now, I'm not talking about getting so much Botox on your face that it looks like you have great faith. I'm telling you, when God touches your spirit, he'll put a smile on your face. I said, when God touches your spirit, he'll put a smile on your face. Okay, you don't get baptized in pickle juice or lemon juice. You know, don't get uncomfortable when the word is preached. Let the fire of God touch you. You know what I like to do with the fire? I like to get as close to it as possible. You know why? Because fire likes fire. Our God's a consuming fire. Amen? I don't sit in the back as far as I can. I sit up front as close as I can. Let me just say something. I know I'm not giving you guys a bad, you know, sometimes you're in the back because, you know what I mean, you got like two kids back there. Okay? You don't want to get up and down like 37 potty breaks. You know what I'm talking about? So we're with you, man. Don't get comfortable. Don't get complacent. Don't let the fire go out. Don't neglect the spiritual gift that you have. It goes on to say, you received through the prophecy spoken over you when the elders of the church laid their hands on you. Give your complete attention to these matters. Throw yourself into your task so that everyone can see your progress. You know what people can see? Great faith coming alive. You know what people can see? Miracles. Manifestations. They can see someone that was once broke, now becomes rich. Okay, what happened there? Why are you always talking about money? Listen, 2/3 of the New Testament and Jesus' teachings talked about treasures, possessions, and things. It's okay to have things, just don't let them have you. And then questions are always asked in the New Testament. Why are so many of among you sick? When you can come to the elders of the church, that the prayer of faith can make a man well. Can God heal people? So let the phone calls begin. Don't go another day without prayer. Use the word of God because the word of God works. A prayer of faith makes a man well. James 5. Give your attention to these matters. Throw yourself into the task so that everyone can see your progress. And it says this, keep a close watch. Keep a close watch on how you live and on your teaching. Stay true to what is right for the sake of your own salvation and the salvation of those who hear you. With every person standing, in close, we're closing right now. This is just a testimony Sunday. I'll preach this message second service. I wish we could all be together. We'd be here for another hour or two. Someone says, well, thank God we're in like, you know, two services, okay? If you're thinking like that, what's the point? We're here to worship God. We're here to receive the word of God from the man of God. Amen? Hallelujah. How many need a breakthrough in their life? Honest. I need a breakthrough. I need a breakthrough in my marriage. Okay, let's not go through the motions. Okay, this is an emotional motions church. Okay, this is the church of the living and risen Savior, and his name is Jesus Christ, the God of all breakthroughs. Hallelujah. Oh, friend, he can break through into your situation. Let me fill you up with some faith today. Let me light your fire. Hallelujah. If you need a breakthrough, I'm going to give you an invitation really quickly in closing. We're going to get you out of here within 8 minutes. okay? Because I don't think God needs all day to do something great. I think God can say one word and everything supernaturally turns around. Come on, anybody else believe that? I just need a word from the Lord. Now, I've already got my breakthrough. Now, I don't need anybody else to stir my gift up. Let me say something. You are all gifted. That spiritual gift is the gift of faith. Faith is the breeding ground for miracles. If you need a breakthrough, I need you to get to this altar right now. Come on, quickly, 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 quickly. What you believe in God for, come on, let him do it today. I believe he can do it right now, in this moment. You'll see it in just a few. If God releases his word today, guess what, friend? It's going to happen. It's going to happen. He's the God of breakthrough. Hallelujah. And his hands are lifted to the Lord. He puts his trust in the Lord. I promise you'll never be put to shame. Hallelujah. And just begin to ask him right now with your mouth. Maybe you don't want the person next to you, so just kind of whisper it. Whisper it to the Lord. Guess what he hears? Whispers. Guess what he speaks in? Whispers. Come on. Just begin to talk to him right now. With every person standing, come on. Stand in the gap for these people. Come on. If you love these people and you love this church, I need you to pray for these people right now. Come on. He's the God of breakthrough. He's the God of restoration. He's the God of increase. Come on. Anybody want to level up in here? Get to these altars right now. Come on. Come on. Don't stay. It's not status quo. It's status go. Okay? Come on. We're going to go up, not down. It's time to move forward, not backwards. Hallelujah. Restoration. Breakthrough. Lord, right now, I pray that you'd sweep across this room. Come on, meet every person's faith according to the measure that they have. Lord, fill them up. Fill me up, God. Hallelujah. Lord, in these moments right now, I pray for supernatural turnaround. Supernatural turnaround. Come on, supernatural. Come on. This isn't an organization. This is an organism. The church is built by Jesus. It's his church. We are the sheep of his pasture. He is the great shepherd. I care about you. He cares about you way more. You know what he wants to do? Something miraculous for you. He just dares you to believe. I dare you to trust God. I dare you to believe. I dare you to put all of your hope and trust in the Master. Let the Master touch your life today. Come on, just begin to thank him as if it's already happened. Come on, that's faith. Faith not only believes, faith thanks. It thanks the Lord. I thank you, God. Hallelujah. That even though the doctor said that we'd probably never have kids, I thank you that your word and your vision that came into my life showed me that your word is more powerful than any word from a doctor. And we stand with four children now. When that factory came open, it came open. It's open. He opens wombs. He opens doors. He opens hearts. Hallelujah. Open up your heart to Jesus. And let the Spirit of God flood your spirit today. Now just begin to praise him. Hallelujah. For his faithfulness. For his eye on you. Thank him. Hallelujah. And praise him. Praise him for the miracle that you just received. Come on, I believe by faith we lay hold of the promises of God through these great and precious promises, hallelujah, that we take part in the kingdom. Hallelujah. With every hand lifted all over this room today, Father, I pray that you build their faith up, that you take their faith to another level. I'm thankful that we get to be part of this kingdom. Lord, I'm thankful that we all have a place in this kingdom. And I'm thankful that we will see the hand of God in the earth today. Jesus, let us be ready when you come. Let us be without spot or wrinkle. And let us be full and overflowing with your goodness and with your grace. We pray all these things in Jesus' name. And all of God's people said amen. Now I want you to reach up into heaven and take what you need. Come on. Hallelujah. It comes from Him and not from me. Hallelujah. Now go ahead and just clap those hands, all ye people, and make a shout unto God. Hallelujah. God bless you. Go and sin no more.